Guys, in today's video, we're going to be looking at how to control servo motors using Raspberry Pi PICO. Step 1, wiring. Okay guys, so let me explain the wiring of this machine. We got this external power supply here, and we got its ground and VCC. Then we got this GPIO0, which is connected to signal pin of servo 1, and we got this GPIO1, which is connected to signal pin of servo 2. Then we got this physical pin 3, which is also the ground pin of Raspberry Pi PICO, and is connected in the same row as the ground pin of the external power supply. And then we got the VCC of servo 1, which is obviously which is connected in the same row as the VCC of external power supply and the VCC of servo 2, and they are obviously connected to the VCC terminal of the servos. Yeah, okay, so then we got the ground, which then we got the ground pins, which are all obviously connected to the same row in the same row as the external power supply and the ground of the Raspberry Pi PICO. And the other side of these wires are connected to the ground terminals of mini SG90s. Setting up the Pi PICO and coding. Okay guys, so here we are on my desktop. I'll just plug the USB cable into the Raspberry Pi PICO and here this boot cell button. We are on the default page of the Raspberry Pi PICO. Now I'm just gonna install MicroPython onto the Raspberry Pi PICO, which by the way is a Python framework that lets you code microcontrollers like Arduinos, Raspberry Pi PICO, and ESP boards. Yeah, okay, so I'll just drag this MicroPython file onto RPI RP2, which is the folder of Raspberry Pi PICO. And yeah, also if you guys want to install MicroPython, I got a video on my channel. I'll give the link to it in the description and in the end card, so you go watch that video after this one. And okay guys, so here we are in Thonny. Thonny is an IDE, an integrated development environment. So first, when you'll install Thonny, this local Python 3 will be the default language selected here, but yeah, as we're programming Raspberry Pi PICO and we got MicroPython installed, so we'll just use this one. Okay, so now let me explain the code now. So first we imported pin and PWM function from the machine library, and we imported uTime, which is the time library, and here we defined that GPIO0 is using PWM signals, pulse width modulation signals, and same here on servo 2, which is GPIO1, which is connected to GPIO1, and both of them are using a frequency of 50 Hz. Then we got this infinite loop here, since we have put this while true here, and after that it's gonna print start point, and this servo.duty_u16 is a built-in function that's gonna make the servo move at a certain angle, at a specified angle to be precise. And yeah, and this 1350 is about 2% of the duty cycle, which an SG90 servo uses. And yeah, it's gonna do that for 1 second, since we have put this time utime.sleep here. Yeah, it's the servo 2 is gonna do the same, and after that it's gonna print endpoint, and servo 1 servo1.duty_u16 is 8200, which is about 12.5% of that of the duty cycle, which also an SG90 uses, which are the servos we were using in this project. And after that, it's gonna, you know, servo 2 is gonna do the same. And yeah, it's gonna do it for 1 second. That's it. Testing. Guys, I'm just gonna run this code here on my computer. There we go. Guys, thanks for watching, and guys, if you like my content, please give a thumbs up and subscribe my channel.